Hey guys, it's Kim Dai here, welcome back to my channel. In the past month, I've made a few videos where I've been trying on prom dresses that I've gotten online. It seems like a lot of you guys enjoyed those videos and found them helpful. So in today's video, I'm going to be trying on prom dresses that I got on Wish. Now I know it's towards the end of prom season, but I ordered these dresses about a month ago and it took a while to come to me. So finally, I got them a few days ago and I thought that it would be a waste if I didn't film this video for you guys. I'll go into more detail at the end of the video in terms of shipping. The reason why I started making these videos is because when you shop online, especially on these Chinese stores, what you see in the picture may not be what you get in person. I personally have shopped on a lot of these Chinese websites because they are very cheap. It is a hit or a miss. Sometimes you get something that looks almost the same as the picture, sometimes you get something completely different. It is a gamble, but sometimes these clothes are so cheap that you just can't help it. So I thought by making videos like this, it'll be helpful for you guys if you guys are also interested in purchasing on these cheap websites, so you will know what you will get. Anyway, just before I start this video, if you guys haven't yet, make sure you subscribe to my channel, turn on a notification bell so you won't miss another video from me. But in today's video, I am going to be trying on 5 different prom dresses that I got on Wish. All the dresses that I have gotten from Wish are all under $20, so they are very affordable. Let's start the video. This is dress number 1. I paid $16 for it, and on the website it says originally it was $120. Now if you guys watched my previous Wish video, you will know that Wish puts like outrageous prices as the original price and then make the selling price really cheap, so it makes it look like you're getting a better deal than you actually are. First impressions of this dress. Oh boy, I don't have a good feeling about this, and I'm kind of regretting getting these dresses already because this dress does not look anything like the photo. This is the biggest problem when you are shopping online. So the problem with these Chinese stores is that they take and steal photos from a lot of different websites and then they try and replicate the item. Now sometimes it looks similar, but sometimes it can look nothing like the photo and just look like a really, really cheap copy. Unfortunately, in this case, it looks like a cheap copy of an item. So let me lay down for you what is different. I mean, if you look at the photo and this, it's very obvious. First off, the color is totally wrong. This is like a bright red color, whereas in the photo, it is a dark wine red color that looks really nice. With the material used, it actually feels really comfortable, so that's good. However, the material in the picture and the material in person is completely different. First of all, the sleeves. In the picture, the model has sheer see-through sleeves with some floral detailing, but there's not too much floral detailing. The one I have is just a lace sleeve. It is quite big, so I got this in a size small. In the picture, it looks very fitted. However, the one I received, it's still quite big. As you can see, I can grab quite a lot of it. In the picture, it looks like there is a ribbon that ties around the back. I don't have that ribbon on this dress, so I guess going from this material to this satin material, it just looks quite cheap because there's no detailing to kind of separate these two. And also in the photo, the dress just looks really fitted around the waist area. It gives the model some shape, so it looks really good on her. But on me, like, there's just no shape, so it looks very bland and I just feel like it doesn't look good at all. There's a lot more material in the picture because the skirt kind of flows out a lot. But also, one thing I want to tell you guys is that I am short. I'm 155 centimeters, and in the past, all the other dresses I've tried on, they were way too long for me, which is good though, because if you are taller, then it would be okay. Now this dress, even though I'm 155 centimeters, it doesn't even touch the floor for me. Like, let me show you guys with the piano stool. Okay. Please ignore my socks, it's cold right now, but as you guys can see, it doesn't even touch the floor for me and I'm already short. So if you are taller, the dress will be very short on you because in the photo, it looks like it's a very long dress and it's supposed to touch the floor. That is dress number 1. Would I say it's good or bad? Bad, sorry. This is dress number 2. It was $16 and originally it was $120. So when I first put on this dress, I had to take it off straight away and put on a sports bra because this front part here is really, really see-through. I'm not sure if you can tell with this lighting. Look how see-through that is. The annoying thing is that in the photo, it's not supposed to be see-through. So the photo looks like the dress is held together by some spaghetti straps. So first of all, the strap is different. This is not a spaghetti strap. In the picture, the detailing looks like it's white, thick material that is not see-through. But this one here, they use a sheer material and then they just put some detailing on top, which looks completely different to the photo. The top part of the dress, the material feels comfortable. However, the bottom part of the dress, it feels so itchy, so they used some organza, it looks like, at the bottom to try and replicate the flowiness of the skirt, but it just looks really weird. The organza they used just feels really heavy and the skirt part just feels really itchy, especially around your waist. Sizing wise, I got this dress in a size extra small, but I don't think it's an extra small size because it is quite big. As you can see, there is a lot of material space here. So if I pulled it back, I mean, I don't think I can make this dress look better because it just looks so different to the original. And yeah, you can just see the separation between the skirt and the top part as well. It just doesn't look good. Unfortunately, this is another dress that I have to say no to. Next, we have dress number 3. This one was $9 and originally it was $18, so the price is a bit more believable. Now, despite this dress being a lot cheaper than the first 2 dresses I just tried on, I actually really like this dress. Comparing this dress to the photo, it looks similar. You can tell that the material is not the same, but it is quite close. The material used is this soft, stretchy material, so it's quite comfortable to wear. Now, what surprises me is that usually these dresses, I find that they fall off really easily on me, but this one stays on really well. This one is a size small, and I feel like if I just alter this dress by pulling in the dress a little bit more, it would be okay. Like, it doesn't look that bad. I definitely can see myself wearing this dress out. It's also got the leg slit as well, very comfortable to wear, and it doesn't look so bad. So this one gets a thumbs up. Next, we have dress number 4. This was $14 and originally it was $99. So I actually got this dress in 2 colors because I was curious to see what the colors would look like in real life. In the photos, it shows that the dress comes in different colors, but obviously they photoshopped the colors on. With the blue they photoshopped on, it looked really nice in the photo and I knew it wasn't going to look exactly the same. But I thought if I had this in a dark blue, it would look quite nice. It came in a really bright royal blue color, which is not really my color, so I am disappointed in that. First off, the material. It feels comfortable, so that's good. The sleeves look similar, it's not the same because the lace does look a little bit different. This top part here looks similar. Down here on the waist, you do have the ribbon that goes along the side to give you a bit more shape. The skirt part consists of some chiffon and some lining. The chiffon does have some slits on the side as well, like the photo. The great thing about this skirt, it's not see-through because most of the skirts and dresses that I have bought on Wish have been see-through, so at least this one's not. Sizing wise, this is a size small and I think it fits really well. The waist part is perfect, so it gives me some shape to my body, which is nice. Overall though, would I wear this out? I don't know, I think that I won't, just because I don't think this is my color and I think it makes me look a lot older than I actually am. So this dress isn't terrible, but I guess this dress is just a so-so for me. Next, we got exactly the same dress, just in a different color. This one was also $14 and originally it was $99. Comparing this to the photo, you can tell the colors are different because yes, the color was photoshopped on, so I guess that's why it's so different. I don't know how I feel about this dress because it just looks so pink to me, like it's just one tone of pink. The material is exactly the same, but the size feels different because this feels a bit bigger than the blue one for some reason. I don't know if it's just me or not, but I feel this one is slightly bigger even though they're meant to be the same size. I don't think this dress is terrible, but I think if they made the top part a different tone to the bottom part, it would look a lot nicer. So this one's still like a so-so for me. It's not completely bad, but I don't know if I would wear this one out. Last one, this one is dress number 5. It was $16 and originally it was $99. This dress is different to all the other prom dresses I've tried on because it's actually a 2-piece. There is a top and a bottom part. When I first took this out of the packaging, I was a little bit disappointed because I took out the skirt part first and I was like, oh no, it feels really cheap. Comparing this to the photo, of course the skirt looks a lot better in the photo. This one is obviously just a cheap copy, but I really like how the top part looks. Now, when I first put this top part on, I was like, hey, I can probably wear this top part with other outfits, but I don't think I can now after wearing it for a couple of minutes. The material used is extremely itchy, so at the moment I just can't stop moving around. I just want to keep scratching myself. I don't think I can last more than 10 minutes in this top because it's just incredibly itchy. I got this in a size small and it fits really nicely. The skirt also sits really nicely on my waist as well, so Yeah, I'm happy with how it looks, but I just really don't like how it feels. The skirt feels very comfortable, but I do wish that the material was a bit thicker because it looks so much better. And I wish that the material wasn't like this satiny, shiny material as well. But overall, I really do like this dress and I would love to give it a thumbs up because I love it. It looks really nice. But I have to give it a thumbs down because it's just so itchy, I can't handle it anymore, I have to take it off. That is all the dresses. Now, if I was to be honest, the only dress I liked was dress number 3, the black dress, because it was the only one that looked decent and the only one that I would wear out. The rest of the dresses, I mean, okay, the last dress was nice, but it was just so uncomfortable. After wearing the dress for about 5 minutes, I just had to take it off. I couldn't handle it anymore. As for the other dresses, I think you guys know how I feel because looking at the dress and the photo, they were completely different and they were just very unflattering. Like I said at the start of the video, buying on Wish is a gamble. Was it worth it? To be honest, I don't think it is worth it because I only found one dress out of 6 dresses that I liked. So that was less than 20%. However, to be fair, I think if you were to purchase very plain, simple dresses like dress number 3 against more fancier dresses, those ones would definitely not look like the photo because you are paying less than $20 for them, so you can't exactly expect too much from them. Anyway, when I bought all these Wish items, I actually did a massive haul, so I do have one more Wish video coming up, so hopefully that video wouldn't be a fail as well. Since all these dresses came from different sellers, they shipped at different times and I received them between 1 to 4 weeks. Dress number 4, I actually received that within 1 week, so that was super fast. However, there was a little bit of a mix-up. Now, this isn't really Wish's fault, but I did reach out to them for help and I think that I probably should tell you guys. So Wish does have a tracking system, which is great. So when you receive an item, the postman will scan it and then it will go to the system. And then on your order page, you can actually track your item. So once it's delivered, then it will tell you when it got delivered and what date it got delivered. Now dress number 4 actually got delivered after 1 week because I was just checking out my order page and I saw that it was sent to my place and arrived at my place the day before. So I was like, that's strange because I haven't received any packages. I went to my mailbox, looked inside, there was nothing there. So I went to my post office and I asked them if there was any packages for me and they said no. So I found it quite strange because on the Wish tracking, it said that that package had arrived. I was a little bit nervous because I was like, look, I mean, I didn't pay that much for the item, but I still paid for them, so I still want my item. So I decided to message Wish to see if they can help me out. I explained my situation to them and it took them about 4 hours to reply back to me, so it was quite fast. But the reply was quite generic. They were saying that they understood what I was saying. On my tracking, it said that the item had arrived, but I have not received it yet, and they told me to wait 1 month because sometimes apparently the item may say that it has arrived and been delivered, but it's not delivered yet, it'll arrive in a few days. And I was like, that's very strange because from what I understand, the postman will scan the item and then it will be marked as delivered. So the postman or someone must have scanned the item as delivered and put it somewhere or taken it, I don't know. And if after 1 month, if I haven't received it yet, it's going to be much harder to follow up on the item. So I sent another message to Wish and I was like, hey, is there anything else I can do? Because from what I understand, if the postman scans the package, that means that it has been delivered, but I don't have the item, so can you just help track down my item for me? And then about 2 hours later, I got another reply from Wish and they pretty much copied and pasted the exact same reply. So I was like, okay, it's automated, so that means I'm probably not gonna get any help here. Whilst this is all going on, I also messaged Australia Post and I was like, hey, what's going on? And they called me, they told me that they would track down the postman to see what's going on. Anyway, during those few days, I decided to try and find this item and track it down myself. And I actually found the item. The postman put it in the wrong mailbox. So luckily, he put it into my friend's mailbox, so I was able to get my item. So even though it wasn't Wish's fault, the customer service, it wasn't that great because it was all automated. But end of the day, it worked out fine, so I got my item in the end. The rest of the dresses took about 2 to 4 weeks to arrive, so about a month in total for everything to arrive. For shipping, I believed I paid about $4 to $5 extra per item to ship. But anyway, that's the end of this video. Hopefully you guys found it helpful and hopefully you enjoyed it. If you guys haven't yet, make sure you guys subscribe to my channel, turn on a notification bell as well, so you won't miss another video from me. Also follow me on my vlog channel as well, because you get to see what I get up to in my everyday life. Also follow my Twitch, because I do live stream on there at least 4 times a week, and you guys can just come and chill with me while we play games and chat together. Follow me on my social media if you haven't yet to keep up to date with me. And also let me know in the comment box down below what other videos you want to see from me. Thank you so much once again, guys, for watching. I love you all, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys!